heart, but it ain't on my sleeve. I don't wanna be the one who bleeds. Hey, I'm looking for love, ready for war. Hey, I'm looking for love, ready for war. So I wanna find someone who bleeds, but sometimes things ain't quite the same as in love.
Chuck Smith and the Restless Hearts, welcome to the Print Shop.
Good to be here.
Thanks for coming by.
Thank you, buddy. Thank you.
So, Tuck, tell me how this thing got started, the Restless Hearts. I know you were in the Biters before.
Yeah.
And you had one hell of a 2020 planned.
Yeah.
New record release, one huge tour planned with Motley Crue, Def Leppard, and it seems to have all got squashed because of COVID. Yeah.
Yeah, I mean, it's been a wild ride in the gamut of emotions. To make a long story short, going from my previous band, the record label, I was kind of forced my hand to break up and go solo. And I had fortunately had a bunch of songs written, and Ricky was playing in my old band. And so we went and made a record out in L.A., and I took Ricky, and we worked with a crazy super producer, Rob Cavallo. We made this giant rock record, and I'm like, well, I'm gonna come back and take on the world. And then I met these guys, and we put a band together, and we landed the big stadium tour and some other tours, and the record was coming out in June of 2020, and everything was like really falling into place, like the virtues of my hard work. And I was so like, I felt like, oh man, this is, everything's happening. And then COVID hit in March, and I'm like, this shit'll be over. And by April, it'll be done. And unfortunately, it's been way over a year. And so that tour was canceled, and you know, my record's in limbo right now. And I was pretty upset about it, but you know, we were talking about it earlier. You can either whine and be depressed, or you can figure out how to bounce back. And so that's what I've been doing, planning how to get my revenge on COVID this whole time.
There ain't much pity in this cutthroat city where the wolves and wild things roam. Shattered dreams and dead in streets, wayward souls overflow. It shines like diamonds, burns like gold. I'm gunning for glory, riding on hope. I got the neon city blues, searching every avenue. The stars are blinding me. I had a little too much to dream. I got the neon city blues. What's a poor boy to do? The stars are blinding me. I had a little too much to dream. I got so close. The honey from the jar, but now I'm left standing stranded on the corner of Broken Heart Boulevard. It shines like diamonds. such a beautiful sight, but sometimes the starless skies ain't always what they say. I got the neon seed air blues, such a name.
What's your relationship with these guys? Tell me.
I have no idea who they are.
We just met earlier today.
Listen, I will say this.
How do you know Nigel?
I'm not going to speak for everybody, but I will say this. I've been in bands my whole life, and I talk about this a lot in interviews and things about how I came from like the punk rock scene, and you romanticize the drug addictions and the partying and the Keith Richards and Johnny Thunders, and I love that, but it really attracts a lot of wild motherfuckers, and there's a lot of pitfalls involved, and I love it. It's who I am. I really wanted a band that had their shit together, and I'm like, that is an impossible request from the universe. And I was wrong. Really, these guys are a great group of guys. They're super driven. They want to be here. They love their craft, and they practice, and so I'm so proud to be playing with these guys, and it's wild. We found Shane working damn in a consignment shop in Nashville for high-end clothes.
No way.
And
friend of a friend.
Dude, we could not
that
find
shirt is money.
Yeah, shout man. Out Tobin. Thank you.
But he's a gangster. Love the best dress. Shame up. and I met Nigel. No offense to Nigel, I had heard about him before, but I thought he was like in this weird butt rock band, and he'd be like some redneck or something. And I was like, I have no idea. He's legendary. Probably like this. I don't know, like a Duck Dynasty type character that wouldn't fit with me. And this sounds really stupid, but I was in a hot yoga class and I was like in these little underwears. And the owner knew him. And then he goes, I want you to meet my friend Nigel. And I came out. And I was like, oh, this is the drummer Nigel? And he goes, yeah. And he just left his band. And I was like, oh. So we hit it off.
Perfect time.
Right off the bat.
Perfect time.
Yeah, right off the bat. Mm-hmm. And Ricky, we've been playing in mutual bands, like, camaraderie with other bands.
Yeah, since about like 2010.
Yeah, since we were just wee ones. And so he was free, and it just lined up. And then Wes, we went to high school together, and we were in rival bands. I was in a punk rock band, and he was in a pop rock band.
Uh-huh.
And I didn't know shit about music, but I had an attitude, and he was learning Beach Boys harmony. So, and now
AOL Instant Messenger wars between his punk rock band and my like wannabe pop band.
They covered.
Leave every night like a Saturday night. You do anything for the
Well, the type of music that you play has really gotten my attention because at my core, you know, I love fucking metal band. I love heavy metal. And you guys are a function of that. That's a part of who you guys are, right? Yeah. And yeah. I can hear the influences. You know, I hear Bowie. I hear Tom Petty. I hear Motley Crue. I hear that stuff. So, well, like, people said rock is dead. No one fucking told you that. That's for sure.
Way.
It's a mission to us at this point, like for me to do guitar rock, and because when you talk to people in the industry, like we were saying earlier, they go, you know what's really hot right now? This kind of drum beat and this right here. And a lot of time bands and artists will go, okay, yeah, whatever it takes to do it. And at this point, I'm just kind of like, fuck that. I want to make pure uncut rock and roll, the kind that I love. And if it's not popular, I don't give a shit.
The way that the songs that we love were written.
Yeah,
there was, you know, any fundamental, you know, even the bands that influenced Petty and Motley Crue and them, they just went into a room and banged out songs that appeased them, and it connected and it you know, resonated because it was authentic.
It was very authentic.
There's a magic to that you can't beat.
And, I read Tom Petty's book recently, man, and they were talking about the recording of "Damn the Torpedoes" and just how it's natural amazing. That was. Even letting you know the sound of the room happen, right?
Sure.
You know, the ambient noise and just all of that, the natural.
And it's one of the greatest records of all time.
It's one of the greatest.
Except there with "Back in Black" to mean some other stuff. Mm-hmm. You know, I will say about the music industry, because there's not as much money in it, people are willing to bend over and take it in the ass a little bit. And if you look at a lot of big songs, there's 8, 9, 10 songwriters on there. if you go look at a Bowie record, it says written by David Bowie. If you look at a Tom Petty record, it says written by Tom Petty and some members of his bands and whatnot. You know what I mean? Like, it came from personal experiences and the songs meant something. Now you get in a room and they go, oh, what's hot? Blue rhymes with shoe. And so to me, it's losing some kind of that... whatever, if there's a magic to it or something that's real, that's to make a difference. So it's art, and yes, there's a business part, but let the artist be the artist.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Yeah, the uniqueness.
Yes.
Yeah.
Same old you.
Yeah.
Tell me where same old you came from.
Same old you, I just talked shit on co-writing, but I love to co-write with people. It's one of my favorite things to do, is to co-write with talented people, because there is a beautiful energy in the collaboration when you sync up energies. And I have a couple co-writes on my record, and they're people that I really respect. And I co-wrote that song with Butch Walker. He's an Atlanta guy. And we had really good chemistry, and the song sounds like a classic to me. I thought it was gonna be, you know, up there with like "I Want You to Want Me" and stuff. I think it's a great tune. And it means a lot, because we banged it out in a day. It was like we didn't overthink it, we just did it. So one of my favorite songs that I've ever written and got to work on with somebody. Yeah. And you know, Butch Walker being from Atlanta is great. It's just a camaraderie.
I think it was the first one that we tracked on the album too.
Yeah, first
one. So it was day one, first song, that was the one.
Blowing hearts, yeah.
You did a record recently that you just released, some cover tunes.
Yeah.
So tell me about that.
So, yeah, I was going to say this and I lost my train of thought. One of the very positive, beautiful things about COVID is not being able to leave the house. I was able to sit at the piano every morning and write. And I was also able, I have a little recording set up. I can just do it at my house, so I just, you know, used the time and did some cover songs and really spent some time on it and tried to make it great. And I did it in my attic, and it got on some like really big playlist and stuff. And it's cool because you can do stuff DIY. And you know, I wanted to stay busy and keep stuff going out there, and I was like, it'll be cool to just record it in my attic. I was doing live streams from my attic, and it was like just my space. So yeah.
Yeah, the cover's outrageous. I love the cover.
Yeah, I love the David Bowie one. That was so hard to do.
No, not the cover of the song. The artwork. Actual cover. The artwork.
Yeah.
I'm into yoga, but I'm also a fucking crazy motherfucker, and it's like a weird balance. And so, yeah, I tried to capture it.
That's funny, man.
Check it out. Yeah.
I was butt naked.
Were you really butt naked?
No, I had some little David Rudolph songs.
Italian Man Nigel.
Yeah. So you're a Georgia boy, right?
Yes, sir. Middle Georgia, like
Middle Georgia.
Yeah, like Lamar County, Barnesville, Griffin.
Yeah, I grew up in South Georgia.
Okay, cool. Well, so we didn't end up selling meth in a Taco Bell parking lot.
No, we did. Hey, buddy. Probably a couple years old.
You made it out.
Now we just buy meth in the Taco Bell.
Allegedly.
Yeah. We used to hang out by the dumpster behind the Hardee's, you know, party a little bit.
Carl's Jr.
You played a song called Sadie tonight. Yeah. And I know that's near and dear to your heart.
Yeah.
And you said all of it's true.
Yeah.
And tell me a little bit about Sadie.
Sadie's about a lady that I know that basically saved my life because, like I say before, I usually sing about the cautionary tale of rock and roll. And the difference between like a band like Motley Crue and kind of the stuff that I write is I don't sing about doing cocaine in a hot tub with strippers because that was not my life. I came from a very blue-collar background. So I usually sing about the cautionary tale because when you don't have the platinum records, it's a little bit different, right?
Yeah.
So to me, I was definitely on a trajectory to prison or something up. And, you know, it's a story that a lot of people, I think, can relate because women do save men. And you can talk to say there's not a good man without a good woman behind him. Most of my songs come from a real place.
Yeah. cause I couldn't make my bill. Yeah, you put your money down, saw something worth to save. I know I ain't been the best, believe me, at least I tried it, babe.
The caddy, that was one of the highlights for me. You guys rolling up in the caddy today.
Thank you.
I think that's going to be an iconic picture. Yeah.
Your Cadillac is amazing.
Think clean.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. I mean, you guys made it look a lot better, I got to tell you.
Just so you know, we were driving through the neighborhood, and Nigel kept going, "Let them know you're here, Tuck." And I'd hit that damn horn and go. It was delayed.
Let them know.
It would go.
I need to work on the horn.
It's not powerful, no.
I got to work on the horn.
Have my elbow out the window pane, Chevy wood grain.
We passed this man in like a service van a couple times. Every time we were like, "Woo!" and he didn't even look out.
Just scrolling on Facebook, looking at QAnon bullshit. Did you hear Trump drank some lizard blood and he can fly now? I'm just kidding.
So in terms of evolution, you know, we're always trying to evolve. You and I talked about some of the stuff that we'd been through on a personal level, you know, and that was very interesting. And I always can find some common threads with people here, you know, when you kind of open yourself up, that's what it's about. Mm-hmm. You know, healing and forgiveness and lightening the load, you know. I feel like everybody deserves a break.
Well, like we were talking about earlier, it's easier to kind of be a piece of shit and not care. It's more of a challenge and meaningful when you really try to, you know, do things and have a purpose.
Yeah, it's much more difficult.
It is, and I like the challenge, and we were talking about that.
It's easy to be a fuck up.
Yeah. It's fun. Yeah. It's probably actually a lot more fun. Mm.
It is. I've had plenty of that fun. Yeah. I think you said that's the new punk rock is having your shit together.
The new punk rock is keeping your shit together, being driven, being confident, owning your stuff. Yeah.
Well, I left my heart
out in Georgia. I left it for LA. It's still cold in California when my thoughts stay that way. Well, I lost my head in London. I swear I threw it all away. I'm still running from the wreckage in the messes I have made. Well, here I am, back in the same old situations. Here I am, trying to find the soul-saving station. Yeah, lately it's hard to find a friend when you're on the highway without a name. Here I am, I'm on borderline again. A borderline case. Well, I lost all of my money in some big pissing contest. Praying for second chances is all that I got left. So I set my sights on evil, looking for the promised land. Cause I swore I'd never end up back in East Atlanta again. Well, here I am, back in the same old situations. Here I am, trying to find the soul-saving station. Yeah, lately it's hard to find a friend when you're on the highway without a name. It's here I am, I'm on borderline again. Borderline case. Take a look at my face. Borderline again. Well, I must have cried a million teardrops, buckets at my feet. I guess that it's the soundtrack to beating this losing streak. Well, here I am, back in the same old situation. Here I am, trying to find the soul-saving station. Yeah, lately it's hard to find a friend when you're on the highway without a name. Here I am, I'm on borderline again. Borderline case. Take a look at my face. I'm borderline again. I'm borderline again.
Tell me what you thought about today. Tell me what you thought about the print shop. Have you ever done anything like this before?
Today was one of the best days of my life, so memorable because of all the unexpected events. And to the people watching, if you wasn't here, I can't explain in words how ridiculous it got. So I'll remember this day for a long time.
No, it was great.
Yeah, amazing facility here, and you know, state-of-the-art, you know, production and everything, and the staff is wonderful, and you know, the food's great. So.
I'm just thankful to be doing something band related. Anything music band, like a little bit of normalcy, feels good.
Feels like forward movement.
I think we can all agree with that. It feels kind of like a semblance of normalcy today, right?
Yes.
Having some good people and
rock and roll.
The best thing that I get out of the print shop sessions is meeting new people. That's the best.
Of course,
thing. I love the music. That drives me. That's why we're here. But the relationships. Are the best thing for me. I've made some great ones.
Mm-hmm. I bet.
Super cool.
Because me and you are buddies now.
We're
the crew. We hung out all day. Yeah,
that's right. Yeah,
it's cool.
This was a long day.
We saw 12 hours together.
Bumper pool.
what I like today is we changed a lot of the songs to fit this format. And I told the band what I liked. I said, this is going to be a big challenge for us because it's like being recorded. And I was like, I'm going to strap on acoustic and play them how they're written. They were all written on acoustic or piano. And I said, and then we'll add the band in and kind of blend it. So it was a challenge and it was fun. And I thought the songs translated too.
Yeah, working in, you know, with the songs that we did today, you know, having some acoustic in there as well, and doing the harmony thing, and you know, we're lucky enough to have Wes join us on keys, so it's been a really great experience. You know, thanks so much for having me.
Listen, one of my favorite bands of all time that I think is one of the most underrated, not only band sound and songwriters, is Thin Lizzy. Now, they didn't invent the dueling harmony, but when I started this band, you know, Ricky's a fucking secret weapon. If people don't know Ricky Dover Jr., he should be a guitar hero, and that's what I want him to be. And so it's hard for me to keep up with him. And so we say we got to do that. When in doubt, dual harmony it out.
Right? Dual harmony it out. Yeah.
Wild ones.
man, you guys absolutely crushed it. This is going to be a smashing episode.
Oh, good.
I can promise you that. And I just can't thank you enough for coming out. Buddy, I'm so glad to know all you guys.
One of the best days of my life. Like, seriously, it's wild.
I'm honored that you're here, and thank you for saying that. I feel the same exact way.
Okay, cool.
I really do.
It's good.
So let's just spread the love, man.
Yeah, buddy.
Thank you for having us.
Keep pushing it forward, right?
Yeah.
So anyway, that's a wrap.
Live from the print shop.
Tuck Smith and the Restless Heart. Check them out.
Thank you, guys.
Oh, he's got a swing. Oh! Oh, shit! No gambling with you, homie. Let's see what you got.
All right.
Let's see what you got.
Stance. Charles Barkley. All right.
No!
Oh. Do you look at the ball when you hit it?
Or oh, yeah. Only the ball.
The whole time.
Yeah, he's a baseball player for sure.
Get in there. Sit down.
Oh yeah. You knew it.
Live at the print shop, baby.
Yeah, man.
Talking about how much I write songs like Oasis and then make them feel like ACDC and Tom Cruise. It's a vibe.
Glad you liked it, brother.